We know from the documentation that's available that within a generation or two after the death of the last apostle, the sacred scripture of the New Testament, especially the Gospels, were read by the Christian community at their Sunday liturgy, the Sunday Eucharist, just as we do today. And in that documentation, the Gospels are referred to as the memories, the memorials, the reminiscences of the apostles. We even know some of the background. Those authors tell us that St. Mark, the author of the Gospel from which we heard the passage today, was the right-hand guy of St. Peter. And so the Gospel is very much the reminiscences of Peter as he preached and told people about what he had seen and heard from the Lord Jesus. I can almost imagine that circle of early Christians saying to one of the apostles, tell us the one about this, or tell us the one about that. Perhaps even in some of those gatherings, there was Bartimaeus himself saying, Peter, remind everybody about the day that the Master helped me to see. We hear again the reminiscences of the apostles, so that we too are in touch with Christ himself through them. Now, a simple point to take from the gospel we have heard for today is that Jesus is the Messiah. He fulfilled the prophecy that we heard from the book of Jeremiah in the first reading. But there's oh so much more for us, so much more light for us, I think, in today's gospel. Because this story of the healing of the blind man, Bartimaeus, is told and retold and told for us today, because it's every Christian's story. It's my story. It's your story. It articulates who we are as disciples of Jesus Christ. And so I want to spend some time thinking about that with you today. First of all, it's my story and your story because we have already, all of us, felt in our hearts the need to cry out in the middle of our troubles. Jesus, have pity on me. We feel that in the lives that we live. And especially we feel it, I know I feel it, when I experience a certain blindness, when my experiences don't add up, don't seem to make sense, when I can be blind or miss, or it seems befogged about the way that God is near and trying to care for me. That's a kind of a blindness that every disciple experiences from time to time. And in that blindness, and in calling out to the Lord to heal us and have pity on us, we can often feel rebuked, as was our buddy Bartimaeus, our fellow disciple, our brother. Rebuked, perhaps, by the world, feeling that the world, at least implicitly, says to me or you, oh, you Christians, you silly fools, to believe in the Son of God and his Father. Or sometimes it's our own hearts that seem to rebuke us as we feel frustrated, saying, yes, I want God's help, I need his pity, I want my blindness to be cured. I want it all to make sense. But feeling that we will never be cured. And then we are again like Bartimaeus, because we haven't bought that lie, that rebuke that says it never will make sense and God is not near. And like Bartimaeus, we persevere in calling out to Jesus, even though the crowd, whether it's the crowd of the world or the crowd of my own feelings, has told us to save our breath, to cool our soup, to use a figure of speech that is not particularly original, I realize. But we do not buy the rebuke, and we persevere. Because of God's grace, God is at work in our hearts. God, by his grace, overcomes our frustration. And we have a sense that we have only to wait on God's good time, that he has a purpose for not answering my prayer today, but he will answer in his good time. Perhaps I'm being tested. Perhaps my love is being purified. Perhaps it is simply better to wait on the Lord and receive the grace I need at a time when he knows I need it most. But that's already faith, the kind of faith that led Bartimaeus to continue to cry out. And there comes for us, as there came to Bartimaeus, in the fullness of the moment, an answer. Lord, I want to see. And he does let us see the truth. He lets us see that it is by imitating his own abandonment of the Father that we are in touch with what really makes sense and what will really bring us happiness. That even in our suffering, he is not away from us. He has not abandoned us, but he's there. We see the truth of what our Master has told us, that if the grain of wheat doesn't fall to the ground and die, it only stays a grain of wheat. But if we die to ourselves and abandon ourselves to the Father, then we really live. We see the truth because we have the eyes of faith, that it is only by losing our life along with Jesus that we will find it. We see the truth that in whatever affliction besets our lives and seems to indicate that God is absent, that even in those afflictions, there is a grace and God is at work. We see the truth of what the priest proclaims every time he begins the Eucharistic prayer at Mass and says, it is right and just always and everywhere to give God thanks. We see the truth that the cross is no longer a symbol of failure, but has become the tree of life, my life. That's why we're here today and not someplace having brunch right now. We believe this. We have faith. We know. We know him in whom we place our trust. This, I believe, is a special grace for all of you who are here today with wounded hearts. Those of you who bring to the cathedral the wound of having lost a baby through stillbirth or miscarriage. Those of you who come into the cathedral today with the sad heart of having hoped by now to have a child and not having that gift. In all of this, you are Bartimaeus. You have perhaps felt blind and not understood how God is at work in your lives. But you have faith, and you trust that in all of this, no matter what the heartbreak, God loves you. And you return that love to God. You imitate Christ. You abandon yourself along with Jesus to the Father, confident that just as the Father didn't leave Jesus in the grave to rot, but he fulfilled the trust of Jesus and raised him from the dead. And you have that confidence too. And by your coming to the cathedral, you help all the rest of us be like Bartimaeus. Your example is an inspiration to me and to the rest of the cathedral community and to those who might be watching on the live stream. Because we all have crosses. We all have things that break our hearts and lead us to feel blind about the presence of God. But we are renewed in faith by the grace, the power of the Spirit of Jesus Christ. We see. We see that what looks like a tragedy, a hopeless dead end to the world, is not. But in Christ, it's one step closer to the kingdom of heaven. We all are Bartimaeus. We all cry out to the Lord to have pity on us. And we all have been cured by the touch of Jesus so that we believe, we see, we recognize. And in the Holy Eucharist, we especially recognize that Jesus, our Master, our Lord, is our High Priest. Here, under the appearances of bread and wine, he is present, and he makes present here on this altar what he is doing right now at the right hand of the Father, saying to his Father, "Thank you, Father. Thank you for your fidelity. Thank you for raising me out of the grave." And what's new, what's different, is today is the 24th. That's right, it's the 24th of October, 2021. And in this day and in this place, the new thing is that you and I make an offering of ourselves along with the High Priest Jesus to the Father. Our sacrifice is joined to the sacrifice of Christ. Our seeing is joined to his seeing, his recognition of the Father. I would point out, to conclude, two ritual moments when you and I get to express this vision of faith, this recognition. One, when we sing out the words, "Hosanna," the victory cry of the armies of Israel. "Hosanna to the Son of David." Hosanna to Jesus, who is victorious over every cross and trial, even the cross of losing a child or not having one to lose. And then, when I lift up the body of Jesus on the paten and his blood in the chalice, and I show it to God the Father and say, through him, through Jesus, with him and in him, is all honor to you, Father. And you say amen, that simple amen, saying by that amen that I am one with Jesus Christ in making an abandoned gift of myself to the Father, and that with Jesus Christ I trust you, Father, and that you are not absent but near, and that you will not abandon me but do great things because I trust in you. Praise be Jesus Christ, now and forever.